Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a really simple, easy, kind of like smoky everyday eye with some big lashes. If you want to know how I got the eye look and some of the skin, keep watching. P.S. I know my lips look a little bit juicy. But I just did get them done. But I did just get them done last night, so they are a bit swollen. They're really sore today, so God help me getting off the lipstick. It's gonna be so sore. If you're interested in kind of like a little journey or like my experiences or stuff like that, like just a short video on it, let me know and I will do one. I didn't actually film myself getting it done, but I mean, I'm sure we can go along together on this journey. But yeah, she did do a lot of corrective work and stuff like that. But anywho's, if you want to know more, if you want a video separately on that, just let me know and I shall do one for you. Anyway, if you want to keep on watching to see how I got this look, then yeah, keep watching. I think I just had that, but anyway, what about bye? What am I saying bye? Just keep watching. What? Hello. Hello. So I've already got my base down. As you can see, I'm already baking. I've just applied some shape tape onto my lids, which I'm just patting in. And then we can get started on our eye look. Okay, so I think I'm going to be doing a warm tone look. Surprise, surprise. Maybe with a little bit of red. So, I need to really stop saying so. Anyway, so I think the first thing, there we go, again with the so. The first thing I think I'm going to go in with is I'm going to go into the Modern Renaissance palette. And I think I'm going to start with Raw Sienna and Burnt Orange. By the way, I got my nails done. You like? I love. Okay, so I'm just going to mix them on a fluffy blender brush. And I'm going to start putting that into my crease. And I haven't set my base at all. I haven't set the concealer. I've been doing that lately and I find that it really makes the shadows stick a lot better, blend out a lot better, and I feel like they last a lot more and they tend to be a lot more pigmented. So I'm just working that in, into my crease, to make sure I've got, you know, a nice looking transition. Next, what I'm thinking of going in with is Rilga, which is right here. It's like an orange, I guess. It's an orange. And I'm gonna work that just underneath where we've placed that crease color. And then what I'll do is I'll just grab a clean blending brush to help me blend out these edges. Dang it, my under eyes are looking a bit crusty. But I think that's okay. We can fix that. So I'm really building, especially, you know, in the outer corner, I'm really building the intensity there. I want that to be quite intense. And then switching over to the clean blending brush and just blending that out. I tend to hold my brush as well, like from a distance, but like towards the end of the brush, I don't know if you can see that, I just feel like it gives me that lighter hand than if I was to hold it like that. I'd be going in a bit too heavy-handedly. Now I do like to take my shadows a wee bit high, but if you don't like it that high, you don't need to have it that high, so don't stress. You can customize this to your liking. Take your time with your blending. I don't think a lot of people realize how long blending takes. I feel like if you take your time, you know, use a clean brush in between the brushes that you're using, it really does, it makes a huge difference. Next, I'm going to go in with red ochre because I want, you know, a bit of red, but I also want, what was I saying? I want a bit of red in my look, but I don't want it to be too overpowering. I still want it to be in that kind of like neutral family. So I chose red ochre because it's got that red, but it's also browny, if that makes sense. And I feel like it's part of the neutral family. I hope it makes sense. If not, I'm so sorry. But I'm just gonna put this right here in the outer corner. And nowhere else. Just like so. Then I'm gonna use that semi-clean blending brush that we were using for our crease. And I'm just going to blend that out. You can build this up to the intensity that you'd like. You don't necessarily have to do it as intense. If you want it a bit lighter, you can do it a bit lighter. Like, don't feel that just because I keep applying that you need to make it as dark as this. If you don't feel comfortable wearing it as dark, you don't need to. You know, makeup is all about what you like. You know what I mean? So I'm going to go back in with that same brush that I used, the Real Gar Raw Sienna and Burnt Orange. And I'm just going to blend that over the top. Not onto red ochre, but just over the top of it. I just want more of that, you know, that browny colour to show through. Okay, and then because I've got it like this, I can now see exactly that I do want a bit more red. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually, as much as I don't want to, I do want it to be a bit more intense. So I'm going to mix red ochre with just a little bit of Vienna red. So just a smidgen. And I'm going to pop that where we've placed red ochre. So just doing exactly what we were doing before. So I'm just going to continue to build that color up in the outer corner. I'm really just focusing it on the outer corner, nowhere else. I don't want to take this color too far in. I'll go back in with that other blending brush just to blend out these edges here. I think I might bring that the red ochre and the Vienna red just a tinsy wincy little bit higher than what I've got already, just a little bit, and I'll blend that out. Yeah, I like that a lot. Again, just making sure I've got that mainly in the outer portion of my eye, so something like that. Just on a little smudger brush, this is a Royal and Langnickel mini smudger brush. I'm going to go into Cypress Amber, which is just the dark brown in that palette. I'll show you guys. It's just this one. Oh my god, did I do it again? I did it again. I did my fingernail in it. So I'm just going to get a little bit on my brush, on the tip of my brush. Gonna tap off any excess and I'm gonna apply that to the outer portion just to intensify the darkness a bit more. And I'm gonna kind of like angle it out. Like so. And then I'm actually gonna take the other brush that I used. This was the Petite Eye Blender by Zoeva. I'm gonna dip into my Red Ochre and Vienna Red. And I'm just gonna use them to blend out the Cypress Amber. Then I go in with my now semi-clean brush to really blend that out. Make sure it's all nice and seamless. Just like that. I just feel like it gives, you know, a bit more dimension to the eyes without just using bronzer. You know, I think this is a great look for if you just want that, you know, a little bit. Extra something. Because don't get me wrong, I love just, you know, slapping bronzer in my crease on a normal day, but sometimes you do want to just put in that effort. Okay, so I'm happy with where this is at. I'm going to quickly go do the other eye, and then I'll be all right back to show you what else I do. Okay, so I've matched the other eye. I'm just going to dust off the powder now that we're done with the bulk of our eyes. I'm going to mimic what I've done on the top of my eyes to the bottom. So I'm going to go in first with Raw Sienna and Burnt Orange and put that underneath. Now I do like to smoke it out quite a bit. I just think it gives such a sultry look. Oh my god, my bags don't look that bad in real life. What the hell? And then I'm going to go in with a mixture of Red Ochre and Vienna. I think I'm going to skip Real Gar for the moment. I just want to put Vienna Red. Was that, what? Yeah, no, Red Ochre and Vienna. Oh yeah, I was right, Vienna Red. I'm just going to put that just very lightly underneath. And you know what? I think I'm going to leave the shadows like that. I don't think I want to put Cypress Umber on the lower lash line. Do I attempt a wing liner? Yes. Yes, I do. I do attempt a wing liner. So what I like to do is I like to follow the lower lash line out. Oh no, don't tell me this is running out. It's just like a little liquid one. It's by Steel, did I say that? Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Liner. So I create the wing, as you can see, and then I will double back on it. I'll fill it in, fix it up. But I always try and get the bulk of my liner on first, as in like the wing and the thickness, and because I'm going to be applying some false lashes, I am going to go all the way in just so you know we can hide the band a little bit more easier. Okay, I'm going to leave it at that because if I play with it anymore it's going to end in disaster, so it's just trying to get it to match on the other side. And I think I might do this off camera because I don't think I'm gonna be able to speak. So I will be right back with both wings on. Oh my lord, I got it. Maybe this one's, you know, just a tiny, wincy little bit thicker than this one, but I got it. I'm not gonna play with it anymore because if I play with it more, I'm gonna hate myself for it and it ain't gonna end well. So I'm gonna leave it. Right, I'm going to do my eyebrows next. Can you just focus? Thank you so much. So I'm going to use LA Girl Shady Slim. I was calling this Slim Shady, but it's not actually Slim Shady. It's Shady Slim brow pencil in black. I just got my eyebrows done, threaded, and they look fresh and nice. So I'm just going to, you know, fill in any gaps that I have. So I always start from the bottom. I like short strokes. Very rarely do I use, you know, long, big strokes. I never grow hair here. So I always feel like I have to do my eyebrows. Or else they just look a bit out of whack. I think I want the outer portion a bit darker, to be quite honest with you. Maybe a touch more thicker. Yep, beautiful. I like. Crap. Now this one, I feel like the arch is a bit, it starts a bit too early than this one. So I always draw a line here. And it evens it out. I think that's looking alright. Gonna set those brows into place. So I'm gonna set the brows into place. I'm using my Essence Lash and Brow Gel Mascara. It's a clear. It's a great product. It just gets dirty quite easily. And you can see it. Which is a bit crappy. But I'm really gonna coat my eyebrows with that. Okay, and then I'm going to put some lashes and mascara on off camera because that will take me forever. I think the mascara I will use will be just a coat of MAC Extended Play. And I think today I might use Lily Lashes in the style Mykonos. And this is my first time trying Lily Lashes, so I'm really excited. So I will be right back with them on. Why does it keep not wanting to focus? I don't understand. So lashes and mascara are on. Whilst I've got you guys zoomed in, I am gonna use some inner corner highlights. And for that I'm using the Master Chrome by Maybelline in Molten Gold. And I'm just gonna put that quite heavily into the inner corner. Well, I'll zoom you guys out. Hello. Now, my lips, I have just got them done last night. So they're a bit swollen. She has had to put a bit more on the top lip. So that's a lot more swollen than the bottom, but you know what? What else? Who cares? So I'm gonna be using my Hourglass Ambient Light Bronzer. And I'm just going to put that on my cheeks. Yep, cool. Then I'm gonna go in with my NARS Orgasm Blush. Surprise, surprise. Gonna load that up on my brush and hit the apples of my cheeks. And then sweeping it upwards. I love this blush so, so much. Right, and for the highlighter, I am going to use the Master Chrome again in Molten Gold. So I'm going to load that up on my brush. And we're just going to highlight away. Now I need a mirror for this because I have no idea what I'm doing right now. I'm going to put a little bit on my forehead. Down the center of my nose. Okay, so I'm gonna spritz everything into place. I'm gonna use the Skindinavia, the makeup finishing spray. Get the lid off. Beautiful. By the way, the foundation I'm using is the Hourglass Vanish Stick in the shade Sand. I really like this, I do, I love it. The only thing I have with it is that it's a little bit too yellow. And that's my fault today. Usually I can kind of counteract it, but I didn't use a light enough concealer today. I used my ColourPop concealer in medium 30, which I believe might be something else because they've renamed them or something like that. And the only light foundation that I put in was the Fit Me Concealer in 15 Fair Clear. I wasn't light enough, if that makes sense. Usually when I use a Tarte Shape Tape in Light Sand, it kind of balances it out really well. Okay, so lips and then we are done. I think I might put one more coat of bottom lash mascara. Okay, so lips. Yep, no, you know what? I think we're just gonna go with a nude. But yeah, definitely gonna go with a nude. I'll let me wipe this off and I'll be right back. So I might go in with Tootsie by ColourPop. Still not kind of like the nude I'm going for. Actually, I might go in with MAC Whirl instead. Think that will be better. That red really stained my lips. I'm just gonna color it in as best as I can. And for lipstick, I think I'm gonna go in with Nude Sinner by Lipstick Queen. Yeah, kind of like my lips, but better. Okay. Lips are definitely swollen, but they shall go down. Right. Put my hair down. And there you have the finished look. Question is it really the finished look? So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, give it a thumbs up, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I shall see you guys in the next one. With less swollen lips. Bye.